congratulations on your second book. This is about your 20s. Mm-hmm. You are in your 30s now. Does it seem like it hasn't been that long a time to reflect back on your 20s already?
Well, it's kind of funny because so many of these books are often written by women who are in their 60s and they're reflecting back on their good old days. And so for me, I really was working on this book at largely 32 years old. Uh-huh. And I had kind of just left it. So.
But I mean, I guess that's nice that your memory is probably a lot sharper as to what your 20s were when you write it.
Well, right? There's that sense of like the closeness to it, which kind of brings, I think, a lot of more intimacy.
Because I'm sure when I'm 60, my memories of my 20s will make myself far cooler than I actually was.
Well, there's also the threat of doing that, too, because I'm so close to the experience that I don't want people to judge me as much.
That's true. And also, a lot of the people that you knew in your 20s, they probably are still your friends, and they could say, like, hey, hold on one second.
Well, yeah, you're kind of... Well, that's the thing with being a memoirist, is that you kind of betray everyone in your life.
There you go. And now, so this... You've said this... You wanted this to be your first book, but your first book was about growing up trans and transitioning, and you felt like you had to get that one out of the way. Can you explain what you were thinking behind that was?
Well, I think so often, you know, most of the stories that we have to tell as trans people have to involve around our body. And so I felt really obligated to that when I decided to step forward at 27 years old and tell my story for the first time. And at that point, I think that our culture was at a space where we needed more stories that were a bit more diverse in the trans genre or the transgender memoir. And so for me, I wanted to complicate that by showing someone who was young, who transitioned as a young person, someone who was of color, someone who grew up poor, you know, the opposite of some of the stories we see oftentimes
in
media.
Was it...
I'm, like, trying not to say her name. I know, I'm so shady, I'm so bad.
No,
anyway.
Don't worry. Everybody, by the way, knows that name. That's kind of, So here's the thing. But now, is it nice, is it refreshing for you, because obviously now more than ever, there is a sense that your readership would understand these issues a little bit more than had you written a book about transitioning 20 years ago. Does that give you a freedom as a writer?
It does, especially now, too, you know, being able to, you know, in Redefining Realness, my first book, I really gave people language and definitions because as our culture, we were looking for language and definition. And now, with this book, I'm able to kind of just free myself and just center myself and not have to offer people, like, I'm Janet Mock and I'm trans. Trans is an umbrella term that describes da-da-da-da-da. You know, now I can just be like, I'm trans, and people kind of just get that already. And so there is a freedom to that.
And then you can move on to your life experiences, one of which is that you interned at Playboy?
Yes.
So this was...
That was my big break.
That was your journalist big break. Mm-hmm. And Playboy was not what you expected it to be.
It wasn't. Well, what was so interesting is I remember sitting with a career counselor at NYU when I was in grad school, and I said, I really want this internship, number one, because they paid $10 an hour, and they also gave you school credit.
Wow.
So this was like, this was the jackpot.
Yeah.
And I was like, should I write something a little bit more ballsy? And she was like, yeah, you know, just use your voice, show them your sense of humor, show them that you can, you know, do this work. And I was like, my name is Janet Mock. And I have three years of editorial internship experience. I have, you know, a master's on the way. And I also have a 34D. And it was such a bizarre moment for me because I also got called in. So it made them very interested in me.
Right.
And then I got the job.
Yeah. But maybe it was for the other stuff that you got the job.
Well, it was. But I also think that there was a sense of, like, they're like, okay, she gets that this is, like, you know, a TNA magazine.
Yeah.
So she gets it. She's not going to take herself too seriously. And when I got there, it wasn't really glamorous at all. There were no, you know, girls next door. There was no Hugh Hefner.
The girls next door didn't come into the office every day?
Not.
They didn't punch the clock?
They didn't stop by Fifth Avenue.
So I want to talk. Obviously, there's an interesting time in our country with trans issues because... more of them are being represented on television and in film, in literature. Still not the amount that probably seems fair, but more than ever. And yet, at the same time, we have an administration who's degrading those rights. How do you feel right now about the moment we're living in?
I'm incredibly hopeful. I think that there's a lot to be afraid of, and there's a lot to be outraged about. But I think that what has happened in this moment is a sense of urgency, and I think a sense of us reaching across our differences and our little spaces to kind of figure out how we can link arms and come together and try to resist, right? And so I think that my community, specifically trans folk of color, have largely always been a part of a resistance movement. I think about Stonewall. It was largely, you know, Marsha P. Johnson and Sylvia Rivera who were there resisting and thriving and trying to figure out ways to be creative and take care of their community. And so I think that what's happening now is that a lot more people are outraged and they're trying to kind of figure out kind of some kind of hopefulness through coming together in a community to kind of resist the space.
Well, I cannot tell you how great it is to have someone like you writing these books. I hope you keep it up. I can't wait for your book about the 30s. I hope I'm in that one.
In 5 years. Okay, yeah, okay.
Thank you so much for being here. Jenna Mocker, everybody.